Hello friends, how are you? I hope good. My name is Kailas and you are watching Spoken English Master. Students, few months ago I have uploaded one video, how to introduce yourself, self-introduction. Okay, so I have seen many students have watched that video and they have written their introduction and I have found the same mistakes. Many students have committed same mistakes again and again. So that's why I thought to make this video. Today I will be telling 7 common mistakes which you should not commit while introducing yourself. Many a times we do face some problems while introducing ourselves. Okay, so if you maintain these 7 things, I can guarantee you, you can definitely create a good impression and you can get the job quite easily. So without wasting time, let's get started. See friends, if you haven't watched that video, I will give the link in the I button. From there you can watch that video. My recommendation is, first of all, you watch that video, self-introduction video, then you come to this video and watch. Then you can have clear-cut idea about that. I will not tell the same thing again and again, because that time in that video I have told you how to introduce yourself. I hope you have watched that video. Okay, so now I will tell you some mistakes. Okay, see friends, your number one mistakes, I have seen many students telling my name is this, my name is that directly. They don't greet. They don't use greetings. Greetings means what I told in that video. I told greetings means what? Good morning, good afternoon. Okay, these kind of things. When you see a person, when you meet a person, you have to greet that person. Okay, hello, good morning, this kind of things. Okay, this is called greetings. It depends on time. If you are meeting a person in the morning time, you say good morning. Okay, it depends on time. So greetings you must have to use. Don't ignore that point. It's very important point. Many students don't use it, but you have to use it. Okay, now then next one. Don't use myself. This is the biggest mistake that we commit again and again. I have seen many students using this, myself this, myself that. This is the biggest mistake that we commit. We should not use that word myself. Okay, this is called reflexive pronoun or emphatic pronoun. This thing cannot be used at the beginning of the sentence. We can't start a sentence with this myself or any other self-related words. Okay, so this is prohibited to be used. Don't use that one. What to use? Suppose my name is Kailas. So what should I use? Sir, my name is Kailas. Or you can say that I am Kailas. Okay, this kind of things can be used, but don't use myself. I cannot say myself Kailas, though it is used. I know many people use it, but it's incorrect. So don't use it at the time of appearing in the interview. Okay, so don't use myself. This is absolutely wrong. Next, don't say father name. Here the problem is, many people say like that, my father name is this, my father name is that. Father name means Hindi mein kya hoga? Papa naam. पापा का नाम है कि नहीं, ऐसा बोलना चाहिए कि नहीं हिंदी में, पापा का नाम. तो यहां पे फादर नेम मींस पापा नाम. सो यहां पे क्या यूज होना चाहिए? फादर्स नेम. फादर्स नेम ऐसे एफ ए टी एच ई आर, फादर्स नेम. ठीक है, सो डोंट यूज फादर नेम, यूज फादर्स नेम. ठीक है, नंबर फोर, डोंट यूज एनी नंबर. एक्चुअली व्हाइल सेइंग आवर एड्रेस we tell full address. Okay, this is the biggest mistake that we commit. We should not tell our full address. We should use short address. How? By using these two prepositions, number one in, number two at. Okay, in is used for bigger place, at is used for relatively smaller place. Okay, and don't use any kind of number. Okay, I have seen many students using like this Kolkata 70002, like this kind of things. Don't use any kind of pin number. Okay, while saying address, make it short. Okay, don't tell in detail. If that person wants to know your address, means full address, he will ask you. You don't need to say it. Okay, if they don't ask you, so don't use any number while telling address. I think it's clear to you. Number four point. Number five, very very important point. See friends, hobby. I have seen many students telling like that, sir, my hobby is listening music, playing cricket, cooking. First of all, you have to understand how many hobbies you are telling. You are telling more than one hobby and you are using my hobbies. First of all, if you have more than one hobby, you have to say my hobbies are. That is the biggest mistake that we commit. First of all, if you have more than one hobby, you have to make sure that you are using hobbies are. Okay, so my hobbies are, one thing. Next, I have written this word listen. After listen, after this listen word, we always use to. Listen to. So my hobby is listening to music. मेरा म्यूजिक सुनने का शौक है. तो क्या होगा इंग्लिश में? My hobby is listening to music, not listening music. ठीक है? If I use hear this word, hear means भी सुनना. ठीक है? Hear. After hear, we don't use to, but after this listen word, we always use to preposition. Okay, so that has to be used. So listening to music. ठीक है? And another thing, it's not mistake, but still I want to say. See, suppose 10 people have come for the interview. All will say my hobby is these, my hobbies are these. Okay. What will be the difference between you and these 10 people? Okay. You can say some different things. Okay. Without saying my hobby or my hobbies, you can say I am fond of. Okay. What can you say? Here I am writing. Fond of. Fond of. I am fond of playing cricket. मैं क्रिकेट खेलने की शौकीन हूँ. Means hobby. ठीक है? I am fond of playing cricket. I am fond of listening to music. Okay? I am fond of cooking. I hope you have understood this one. Or you can say that I love to play cricket. I like to play cricket. All are correct. Okay? So, don't use hobby and hobbies again and again. Okay? Use some different things to create good impression. Next one. See, while saying your experience, I have seen many students saying like this. I have been working at this company. Suppose a particular company, any company. I'm not writing any particular name of any company. I have been working at this company from 10 years. मैं 10 साल से इस कंपनी में जॉब कर रहा हूँ. मैं 10 साल से इस कंपनी में जॉब कर रहा हूँ. तो क्या होगा? I have been working at this company from 10 years. I have seen this one. So this is absolutely wrong. It should be for. I have been working at this company for 10 years. Okay? Not from. For 10 years. This one you have to take care. Okay? Next one. And the last point. Don't forget to say your aim. I have seen many students, they don't say aim. Aim is very important. Aim means what do you want to become in future. You may want to become a businessman, you may want to become a singer, whatever you want to become in future, okay, that you have to say. It's very important, okay. So I have told you these 7 points. If you take care of these 7 points, I can guarantee you, you will not commit a single mistake and you will definitely get the job, okay. So I hope you understood this one. If you have understood this one, don't forget to like the video and don't forget to hit the subscribe button, okay. Because we upload many videos like this. If you want to watch all the videos, you have to subscribe to our channel. Okay? So for today, that's all. Next day, again we will meet and again we will learn something new. For today, thank you. Thanks for watching.